Welcome to 2024, and this is Honest Wedding Advice with DJ ESG. I've been in the private event industry for 30 plus years. Over 3,500 events, weddings, sweet 16s, mitzvahs, you name it, I've done it. And this is the most honest, truthful, straight to the point wedding advice podcast you will find anywhere. There's no froofiness, there's no sugarcoating. I tell you how it is all the time. Take it or leave it. I'd rather give you the honest advice than give you some bullshit blowing smoke up your ass. But I'll tell you this, it's short, it's quick, it's to the point, and you will learn something. I'm DJ ESG, the EST of ECEG. Check out the podcast. You will not be disappointed.
What's up, guys? DJ ESG dropping 30 years of knowledge and experience on you. And today I'm talking about, do you need one DJ or do you need two? Well, it depends. It really, really depends on a lot of variables. The venue, the time of the year, how much stuff you have. Can the DJ MC? Can the MC DJ? How many guests you have coming to your event? There are so many variables that determines if you need one guy or two guys at your event, or one guy or two girls at your event, or two girls and one guy at your event, or two girls at your event. I'm up to three now. I don't know how I got there, but I'm up there somewhere. But that's the point. It really depends how many people in general you need at your gig. Sometimes you have 250, 300 people. Two guys are definitely warranted. Can one guy pull it off? Absolutely. Is it every one guy that can pull this off? Absolutely not. If you're in a big space that has a lot of different sections that people can get lost in, two guys is always good. Do you have a venue that knows what they're doing that will bring people back if you need them? Maybe. Then you maybe only need one guy. If your venue's not going to do a whole lot, you might need two guys or two girls or one guy and two girls. I'm back to three again. Point being, one person or two people at your event, or even three sometimes, on the music end of it, the DJ space is really up for debate depending upon a lot of variables. There are spaces where I can do as a one-man show, and there are spaces where I can personally do as a one-man show that normally people should have two or three people at. That's just me. I'm capable of doing that. Is it really good for me every time? No. Load-ins are tough. By the time I'm done some of these load-ins, I'm exhausted, so you don't get the full energy level of Eric, because the load-in is horrible and should be meant for two people. The amount of equipment that goes up, sometimes you need two people for that. If you have a lot of guests, it's hard to be in two spots at the same time. Is it doable? Yeah, but with an easy load-in and not a lot of equipment. So there are so many variables that go into the one-person or two-person entertainment act. I'm telling you right now, there is no cut-and-dry answer to this. It's based on a lot of things, and it's based on a lot of variables. Luckily, after 30 years, I can break all these variables down to you one by one, per venue, per time of the year, per the stuff you're bringing. Once I know all that, or a good entertainer knows all that, they can tell you whether or not you need one person or two. Trust me on this. Don't go into it with the mindset of, I already know what I need and what I don't need. Go into it with the mindset of, these people who I'm paying are going to tell me how many people I need, and they're going to tell me why. And based on that, I'm going to make an informed decision, and that's how I'm going to book my entertainment. There's so much more to this. I can talk about this for hours, but for right now, take this advice. I'll be back with more. I'm going to break this down into different sections about each and every one of these, the one, the two, sometimes the three person show, and explain to you different elements, breaking them down into sub podcasts, because that's what this needs, sub podcasts. It's great advice. Take it or leave it. I'm ESG. I'll talk to you later. Bye-bye.
Do you have the time to listen to me whine about nothing and everything all at once? I am one of those melodramatic fools, neurotic to the bone, no doubt about it. Sometimes I give myself the creeps. Sometimes my mind plays tricks on me. It all keeps adding up. I think I'm cracking up. Am I just paranoid? Am I just stuck? I went to a shrink to analyze my dreams. She says it's like a sex that's bringing me down. I went to a whore. He said my life's a bore. Choke with my white and blood and bringing her down. Sometimes I give myself the creeps. Sometimes my mind plays tricks on me. It all keeps adding.